Numpad 7, or backquote and top to go to the top viewport. Let's create a circle. If you don't see the circle in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. Tab to go to edit mode, G and X to while holding control to move on the X axis while snapping to the grid. Shift D to duplicate. Let's move the duplicated circle like this. Time to add the screw modifier. Let's use the simple deform modifiers bend to bend the mesh 360 degrees on the X axis. We need to apply the modifiers and move the origin to geometry. After that, we need to press Shift S to move the selected to the 3D cursor. Let's rotate the mesh so that the mesh would look like this in our front viewport. Before we align the mesh to the front viewport, let's rotate the mesh a bit so that we can place a diamond on the top of the bracelet. Let's use an add-on called Jewelcraft. Please check the add-ons page to see if the Jewelcraft is there. If not, please use the GitHub address below to download and install. The pre-built diamond creating add-on from Extra Objects is missing materials, so I prefer using the Jewelcraft instead. To add a new diamond, click the Add Gem button. We don't need to work on the material for the new gem, because the Jewelcraft has already created a perfect one for us. Let's go to the front viewport and rotate the mesh properly. The idea is to move the diamond to the top of the bracelet, and use an empty object with the array modifier to place the duplicated instances. Let's add a holder mesh with a cylinder. Let's subdivide the bracelet mesh. Let's apply the materials and join the meshes together. I'll add an empty object, and use it as our array modifier's anchor point. Before applying the array modifier, please select the mesh and Ctrl A to reset all transforms. Let's set up the render scene. Shift D to duplicate the ground plane. I'll add the emission shader for the duplicated mesh and use it as a light. Please watch a tutorial listed in the description to match my final render settings, as I'm using a cloned look dev HDRI setting. Let's turn off use nodes under compositing. I'll also use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Please like and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.